ready to be my canvas? Seem nice and primed. Okay. Yes, very good. I thought I'll do something that I'm passionate about, and it's painting as of lately. So new set of brushes that I would like to test out with you, and learn about each brush and what strokes are best to make with each one. Where we can see each brush explained, the types of strokes that I can do, types of paintings. Okay. And I have this easel. Is it called easel? I think so. That is so nice. For tapping. So I'm going to apply my paints onto it, mix them up, and we can try it, okay? So let's start. So I put on my gloves just so I don't get it on my fingers. Beautiful, bright, sunny day. I'm so glad it's summer. And because it's during the day, we're going to hear some cars and airplanes, and we're going to enjoy it. Because, you know, sometimes I like the sounds of vehicles or people in the background, because it makes you realize that you're not alone. Everyone is out there and is trying their best, just like you are. So, makes me feel good. I hope it does you too. Alright. So, we're going to start with some brushes. I like this brush. It's rounded. Tracing along, smoothing out the lines, so let's read. Here. So round brushes, broad lines, stroke work, and calligraphy. Ooh, let's do calligraphy. I'll write some letters right on your side. First, we need to pick our paint. I vote this color shifting paint, which is red flash. Okay. Oh, it's so pretty. It's actually almost the same exact color as my shirt. And I would like to combine it with this rose copper color. It's a little more liquid though, so I'll put less of it. Okay? What do you think? Not bad. So, let's dip our brush into the water. Mm-hmm. And we'll start with long strokes. Okay. I'm combining both. I love this brush. Nice long strokes. Petal-like effect. It's gonna go like this. See? So I like this. I like some circles right here. Some circles right here. Okay, I like that. Okay, we're good with this. So now let's pick one other one. I would like to try this steppy one. So this one is probably this shader. Good. This yellowish green, which is green flash, also color shifting color, very effective, very pretty. Gonna do just along the way. Okay, looks like a good combination to me. And remember, we're doing some square shapes or some blending. I think it would look good with long, short, no, quick and short strokes, like almost a tree, pine tree maybe, or painting corners. I think that'd be good. So I'll just dip it in water. And let's just start with square shapes. Okay. I'll just do an actual square. This purple one suits you so well. Especially, well, it's green, I guess. continuing making a square. Okay. And I will also make some feathered strokes. Okay. We're not going for any specific composition here or any final result. Just letting our expressionism come through and express itself in whichever way it should or feels compelled to. Okay. Okay. Looks pretty good. Very potent colors. Just a little bit more here. Good. So wash it off, keep two. And we're done with this. Okay. So let's see. Do some smaller brushes. Maybe this one. How about that? Let me see something. So this brush is definitely filbert, round shapes, petals. We should do a contrast combination of aqua color, so it's very water, seaweed kind of color, okay? And we'll combine this aqua color with this yellow shade. Very pretty. Okay. Put a little water. So we'll start combining it. Look how potent the colors are, so saturated. So we're doing petals. You can hear the birds outside. I think some kids are playing too. Well, it is what it is. I wanted to enjoy your company during the day and share my passion with you for painting. Almost green, but you can still see some definition of each color stand out. Looks pretty impressive. Okay, so I'll just continue with this. Oh, I like the purple mixed. purple and yellow is one of the best complementary colors, as you know. Okay, let me do some small petals right here. You know, I'll add some water, okay? Just create strokes that disappear, okay? Just kind of blending it out into nothingness. Usually quite a nice effect. Makes it almost good. So the last brush is this big and thick one. And it's for longer strokes. Beautiful color. Then I'll add some of the white brown. It's an easy choice. Bit more blended look. Okay. And I'll do some feathering. Okay. Oh, that's really nice. It catches a little bit of previous colors and creates almost a smaller layer of pink. Yellow. Leave it at that. I'll remove my gloves. I noted, and I just wanted to share this with you and show you that I care. I wanted to tell you that I would like to make more videos for you and fill them up with more care and more comfort. Pleasant to listen to and watch. That is my goal, and I hope you feel it. Okay.